Hello, I'm Carly McAvoy, looking at systems of equation word problems. This one I just am calling two values. They kind of give you two different values and you have to figure out what's happening. And they can look pretty different. The first one I'm seeing, there's a daycare that has 25 students. The morning students pay $30 a piece and the afternoon group pays $45 each. If they make $975 in tuition per day, how many students are there in each group? So I'm going to say there's two different things we're looking for. I'm going to call morning students, M being the morning students. M equals the number of morning students. You don't want to skip this step where you declare your variables. It helps you understand what you found and what you're looking for. I'm going to say A equals the number of afternoon. Of course, you can just use X and Y. But sometimes if I can use variables that make sense to me, I kind of know what I'm talking about. One of the equations is always just strictly talking about the number of items. So I have M number of morning students, and I have A number of afternoon students, and altogether I have, given in the problem, 25 students. The second equation is going to have to do with the tuition that they pay. So the morning students pay $30 a piece, and the afternoon students pay $45 a piece, and they have a total income of $975. So there's my two equations, and now I just have to solve that using whichever method I prefer. And so this time I'm going to use the substitution method. I'm going to take one of my equations and I'm going to rearrange it. Let's say I rearrange it for M by subtracting A from both sides. So M equals 25 minus A. Now I'm going to take this equation, and where I used to have M, I'm going to replace it with what M is equal to. Remember, you can use calculators whenever you need them. I check my math a lot of times using a calculator because I find that that's helpful. Anyway, this is going to be 750 minus 30A plus 45A is 975. Just distributing there. Notice this equation now only has A in it, so I can solve for the A, which is my afternoon students. So I have, this is actually 30A. You saw that little zero was missing in there. I'm going to subtract 750 from both sides. And I'm going to combine negative 30 and positive 45 to get 15A. Excuse me. 975 minus 750. Is 225, which looks like it's going to go nicely. 15 times, divide both sides by 15, and you get A equals 15. That means that there are 15 students in the afternoon, because I said the A is the number of afternoon students, and that's 15. So how many students are in the morning? Well, I know that the morning plus the afternoon is 25. So if I know that the afternoon students total 15, then I know that there must be 10 morning students, right? So if I've identified my variables up here, I can say, oh, number of morning students is 10, number of afternoon students is 15. It's important to know what you found. So if you just say 10 and 15, but you don't say which is which, that's not telling me that you understand the answer to the question. Okay, let's look at another one where you have two different value. This one has to do with money, and typically if you're doing money and you have to round, you're going to round to the nearest cent, because we always round to the nearest cent when we're working with money or going to the grocery store or something. Aureli invested a total of $5,600 in two mutual funds. One fund earned 4% interest and the other 7%. She earned a total of $302 in interest. How much did she put into each account? So it's like the last one in that we have a number total, and then we have the, like, instead of a tuition, we have interest, but there's a similarity to these. But I'm going to use, I'll use X and Y here. X equals the dollars that she invested at 4%. And Y is going to be the dollars that she invested at 7%. And my first equation has to do with how much she put into both accounts together. So all the money invested at $4% and at 7% totals up to $5,600. Now the second equation, like the second equation above, has to do with the interest earned. Remember when we talk about 4%, we're talking about 0.04. So we have 0.04 interest earned for all the X dollars, and we have 0.07 interest earned for all the Y dollars, and we were told that the total interest earned was $320. So there's our two equations. And you have a calculator, so you're very welcome to just leave decimals in there and solve it. But I'm going to get rid of the decimals. In order to get rid of the decimals, I'm going to multiply everything by 100. That's going to move the decimal point over two places. So I'm going to say this is times 100, and everything gets moved over two places so that this equation becomes 4x plus 7y is 32,000. So that's a common mistake, is people forget to add the two zeros to the end. Now, instead of using a substitution like I did in the first one, I'm going to use elimination. I'm going to eliminate the x's. So I'm going to multiply this top equation by negative 4. Now, the second equation I multiplied by 100 to get rid of the decimals. This one I'm multiplying by negative 4 so that I'll have the opposite of 4x, and then they'll cancel, so I can eliminate those. So bringing that equation down here, I have negative 4x, negative 4y, and 5,600 times negative 4, which is negative 22,400. Okay. And that one's looking a little off to me, because how can we have a negative there if we're going to get a positive over here? Oh, 32,000. No, we're good. Okay. I had a moment there where I was thinking 22 was going to cause that to be negative, but we're good. Okay. We're going to add these two together. The thing that made me give me pause, which I hope that you do the same, is as we're looking at that, we're saying we should never get a negative number when we're talking about how much did you invest in each fund. You might if you were talking about how much did you lose in your investments, but just for money to put in, you can either put $0 in or something, but you can't get a negative amount. So I had a moment there where I thought that was going to be negative. Okay, adding these two equations together, these bottom two equations, you can see the X's go, and we have 3Y is the negative 22,400 plus 32,000. And that is 9,600. And then I'm going to divide that by 3 to get rid of that. And I get Y equals $3,200. What does that mean? What is $3,200? Well, $3,200 is what she put into the Y account, because I declared it up here. She puts $3,200 into that account. Because I knew when I said Y is going to be the 7% account. So then I come back here and say, well, then if she put $3,200 into the Y account and she invested $5,600 altogether, then how much did she put into the other account? And that is 5,600 minus 3,200 is 2,400. So she put $2,400 into the 4% account, and she put $3,200 into the 7% account for a total of $5,600 invested, and the interest she earned was $320. All right, have a fantastic day. We'll see you next time.